Present during the hearing was Colonel Marvin Marcos. He is one of 19 police officers who were implicated in the killing of Albuera Leyte Mayor Rolando Espinosa inside his jail cell in November 2016. They were all acquitted by the Quezon City Regional Trial Court in 2021. Marcos, then chief of the CIDG Eastern Visayas Field Office, led the implementation of a search warrant against Espinosa at the Baybay Municipal Jail. Marcos disputes some of Kerwin Espinosa's statements about the death of his father. During the House hearing, Espinosa claimed some of the jail guards were forced to face the wall when his father was killed.
Sa warrant of arrest na inisyu, Major Larraga filed application for search warrant because of an valid information that there were continuous of drug trade inside the Baybay City Jail. And some of the jail guards are involved.
Sige, Colonel Marcos.
Yung po ang dahilan bakit po kami nag-apply ng search warrant. Kaya po namin in-implement yun. At saka yung sinasabi niya nag-face the wall, hindi po kami pinapapasok sa jail. Kaya po namin ni-restraint yung mga jail guard doon kasi they were armed. Armado po sila. Hindi kami pinapasok. We were forced to use bolt cutter, which is specified in the search warrant that we can break through if the search warrant issued by the judge is not honored.
The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission believes the so-called big boss of illegal offshore gaming hubs, who was captured in Laguna, plays a bigger role in the industry than disgraced Mayor Alice Go. PAOK spokesperson Winston Casho says they have evidence. Chinese national Yu Dong is one of the major financiers of the Philippine pogo industry. He hopes Yu Dong will reveal the identity of the masterminds behind the pogo operations in the country. He was nabbed last night at a residential subdivision in Binian, Laguna. 10 other Chinese pogo bosses and their 7 Filipino bodyguards were also apprehended. Authorities say Liu Dong, who uses several aliases, is allegedly behind the scam farms in the country, including the raided Lucky South 99 in Pampanga.
Boss po siya, one of the big bosses ng Lucky South. Hindi pa po natin na-unmask kung sino yung tunay na godfather of all pogos in the Philippines. Matas ba ito kay Alice Guo? Yes. Our belief is that Alice Guo or Guwaping is merely a front, part of the criminal organization, but merely a front of the criminal organization.
The arrest of a key figure behind the illegal pogo hubs in the country, hailed by senators as a big win. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian calls the arrest of Liu Dong, also known as Lin Shun Han, as a major achievement in the fight against pogo-related social ills. He also underscored the need for constant vigilance in monitoring cross-border activities, including involving high-profile individuals. He also wants an investigation into the Filipino bodyguards and associates linked to the so-called pogo boss. For Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Ontiveros, Liu Dong's arrest brings them closer to getting justice for victims of scam hubs and to hold public officials who tolerated the illegal activities accountable. Ontiveros, however, believes there are bigger personalities behind the pogo operations that need to be brought to justice. A light exchange at the ASEAN summit as leaders discuss regional tensions. The Prime Minister of New Zealand, Christopher Luxon, received a special Filipino gift from President Marcos, a Jollibee toy wearing Barong Tagalog. Luxon was visibly thankful for the gift and even invited Marcos to eat together at the popular Philippine fast food chain. When the New Zealand leader visited the Philippines in April, he ate a Jollibee, triggering Marcos's craving for Jollibee products. Days later, Marcos posted on social media a picture of him and his wife, Lisa, enjoying Jollibee's signature fried chicken.